Hello guys, I'm back with a new series on interview experiences, who got selected in various MNCs. Hope you'll get more useful information in this series. So please do watch till the end. So as a part of this interaction, I would like to call Mr. P. Harshavardhan, who got selected in multiple MNCs. So let me call him on Hangouts. Hey, hi Harsha, how are you doing?
Hi, hi Shekhar, how are you doing? I'm fine.
Yeah, I'm also fine.
How are the things going on?
Yeah, fine. Now I'm working from home due to this lockdown effect. And I'm very busy with some project.
Yeah.
So actually we are planning to have your YouTube series on interview experience with some of our friends. So I would like to listen to you for some of your valuable experiences.
Yeah, sure.
So as a part of this, I would like to ask you some questions regarding that.
Okay.
So what are the companies that you have selected so far?
I got selected for TCS, Wipro and Synopsys.
Yeah, it is very good. You got selected in multiple number of companies. So what is the first company which you have attended for?
The very first interview I have attended for is for Value Labs, the on-campus drive. It was an on-campus drive.
So you got rejected it, right?
Yeah, I got rejected by them. Yeah, the very first interview I got rejected and the very last interview too.
So what do you learn from that rejection, and that is helpful for you cracking further interviews or not?
Yeah, definitely. See, since it was my very first interview, I do have that freaking first interview fear. So though I still manage it till the HR, the very greatest point I have learned is, see, when an interviewer asks you a question, you should be very clear to it and you should respond accurately. No, just as a pinpoint to the question. So that's what I learned in the very first interview. And later on, the later interviews, I cracked very well. All the interviews I attended for, I have selected by them. So that's what I learned.
Yeah. So what is the difference you have observed in all those interviews?
See, every interview will never be the same. See, the interviewer will be different, the company or applying for will be different. So there is a difference in every interview. But as a contrast, you can say that the things that differ is the job role you are applying for, the package they offer, the requirements they have. Those will be the differences between all the interviews. And the remaining things will be the same. The way you portray yourself, the way you present to the interviewer, that's what you should focus on. So there will never be the greatest differences between them. There will be a slighter differences.
Yeah, it's okay, Harsha. Now I would like to ask you some queries that every newbie will have before they are attending for the first interview.
Yeah, yeah.
So the most frequently asked interview question is, tell me about yourself. How do you present that question to the interviewer?
See, the question like, see, every interview and every interviewer will ask the same question for the same person, for the different persons again and again. See, the question, tell me about yourself. See, the question is you call it as very basic thing. Because, the interview will have the limited time, like asking you questions thoroughly one after one will never be useful for him. If you're good at answering the question efficiently, he will have a nice nice impression on you, like, yeah, he can carry on with the other things, whatever I can ask. If you fail to answer the question at the immediate time, he will have an impression like, yeah, he cannot cope up with this job. So the impression will be very important to the HR. So the very basic question will be this. Answering this question is also very important. In my case, I answered it like, starting with my academical details, telling my skill set, the achievements I had, the workshop I attended for, the projects I have done. So I measured all those things and presented and portrayed myself to the HR to impress him.
Yeah, that the good part on you is 100% coding is necessary to crack any interview or not.
100% coding is necessary means, you know, it all depends on the job role you offer. See, if you're appearing for a job which is having less package, like, you know, they need just small technical skill sets, you need not to have 100% coding skills. But if you're applying for an, you know, a large company which is having a high requirement on latest technologies, so and so, you need to have 100% coding skills. So it all depends on the job role you are applying for.
Okay, Arsha. Does the aptitude plays a vital role in hiring process or not?
See, I'm coming to the on-campus interviews. There will be the first round in campus drives, like, you know, written test. So in those tests, maximum number of companies will ask you aptitude, you know, verbal, take coding, MCQs, like so and so. So to crack those tests, you should have some knowledge in aptitude. Having knowledge in aptitude is necessary, but you don't need to concentrate heavily on that. So you should have some clear clarity on it. That's enough for cracking the interviews.
Okay. What do the HR people and technical people will expect from any fresher?
Yeah, you know, when you are about to interviewed by an interviewer, you should keep some things in your mind, like what are the job role you're applying for, what is the mood of the interviewer, and what are the skills you have. So after considering all these factors, you should present yourself. And the interviewer will have some observation on you. The way you present, the way you deal with the questions, you know, when he poses a question, how you give an instant reaction, how you answer that without having any pauses. So these are all factors that will be considered by them. And the way you are solving a question or a puzzle they give, the way you answer to their technical questions, all these factors matters a lot.
Okay, finally, we are into the interview, Harsha. Is there is any suggestion you want to extend to the upcoming freshers?
Any suggestions means, you know, before attending a first ever interview, everyone will have some doubts, like, will I get the job? Will I get hired by them? There will be how the interview may go, how the interview will last, what are the questions they may have. There will be some confusion you get, some nervousness you get. But we have clear clarity on some of the features, like, you know, be confident. Don't be nervous, because, you know, nervousness will lag you back, you know, it will pull you back. So don't have nervousness. There will never be anything wrong there. So be confident, be accurate at telling the answers. Mostly, you know, be good at what you are saying. So try to observe the question clearly. Understand the question clearly, answer clearly. That's what all needed.
Yeah, it was nice talking to you, Harsha. Sharing you lots of experiences to upcoming freshers. And thank you for sharing your valuable time with me. Thank you, Harsha. Thank you. Bye.
Yeah, it's okay. Yeah, good luck to your web series.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye.
Bye.